Herr Dr. Eberhard, ich möchte mit Ihnen heute über ein besonderes Thema sprechen, das etwas...
Dr. Eberhard, I would like to talk to you today about a special topic that is somewhat outside of your area of expertise, but for which you are nevertheless a very suitable discussion partner due to your profound knowledge of near-death experiences. It is about the connection between near-death experiences and quantum physics. In general, quantum physics is very often cited when it comes to paranormal experiences or, more generally, to an idealistic understanding of the world. Sometimes you get the impression that it is all too quantum, that quantum physics is repeatedly and often not quite rightly used as an explanatory model. How do you see the significance of quantum physics for near-death research or even death research? Does it have any significance at all?
I would like to say in advance that I fear there is no real clear answer to the question of a possible connection between death research and quantum physics. So questions will probably remain unanswered even after this interview, because it is generally difficult to answer this question. First of all, it is of course interesting to know why a connection is made between quantum physics and paranormal phenomena in the first place. One often hears the following assumption: the phenomena touches the boundaries of physics, so to speak. Phenomena in the field of quantum physics lie beyond our usual concepts of space and time. And paranormal phenomena, i.e. near-death experiences, show something similar, but not only these. It is therefore tempting to associate such experiences with observations at the limits of physics and perhaps see them as a bridge of another dimension. But ultimately, this all remains quite speculative.
Specifically, what approaches do you think quantum physics offers that could be associated with paranormal phenomena?
This is also a difficult question to answer. I would like to expand on this a little and start with the question, what actually is quantum physics anyway? What leads us humans to see it as a bridge to another dimension? Historically, at the beginning of the 20th century, Niels Bohr, a Danish physicist, presented the atomic model. He offered something that was easy for us to categorize. His model showed that the atom has a nucleus, that there are protons and neutrons, and that these in turn attract the electrons orbiting further away through their charge, not through their gravity. And so we have a picture for the world of atoms that we know from the planetary model. The Sun attracts the planets with its gravitational force. They do not fly away due to the gravitational pull, as one might assume, but move along an orbit that is very stable in itself. This model was very easy for us to understand.
With the atomic model, everyone could easily visualize the structure of matter.
But it wasn't long after Bohr had received his Nobel Prize, only a few years passed, before a contemporary of almost the same age attracted attention, the Austrian physicist Erwin Schrödinger. Heisenberg, a German, and various scientists from other disciplines also brought something completely new and completely different to the stage, quantum mechanics, as it was called at the time. It challenged all our ideas about the world of the smallest things, whereas previously we had always thought of particles of matter traveling along fixed paths. Quantum mechanics was based on a completely different theory, which ultimately prevailed. The smallest particles can be described by a mathematical formula that shows a probability, a wave with amplitudes and frequencies, and it is three-dimensional. There is no longer a classical particle, but a cloud, so to speak, a wave, and it can change shape very quickly. It is also not stationary. It can become balloon-like, so to speak. It can become disc-shaped or spherical. It can mirror itself symmetrically. It can even, and this seems even more bizarre, assume these different states at the same time. This may seem paranormal. This is known as non-locality. The particle is not in any particular place. You don't know where it is. It can only be described as a probability. I'm not an expert in quantum physics myself. I'm just interpreting quotes from scientists here. But as soon as you decide to carry out a measurement in order to determine a specific location for the particle, this cloud, this probability wave, collapses, and then this particle really does appear somewhere. Light can therefore appear as a wave, which can only be grasped with a mathematical formula or as a particle. This is why we speak of the so-called wave-particle duality. The particle appears through observation, and between observations it is this amplitude waveform, frequency, this mathematical distribution. All of this is no longer really comprehensible. But it gets even crazier. In quantum physics, there are also entangled particles, as they are called. This is also something that I don't know from my own research, but have only read up on because it is so often made a topic of discussion. Entangled particles belong together as they can have an angular momentum, a spin. In medicine, we work with such spins in magnetic resonance imaging, i.e., either left or right. If one of the entangled particles changes its spin, its angular momentum, then the other one does the same at the same time. And the crazy thing is that this communication happens without a time delay, faster than light, so to speak, even if the particles are far apart. This means that the speed of light is no longer a limit for the communication of these particles. And that was probably an even bigger shock for physicists, because this observation is no longer compatible with Einstein's general theory of relativity. That's why, as far as I know, Einstein didn't believe in it. He called it spooky action at a distance. Quantum physics has therefore triggered discussions and raised questions that have not yet been answered and that need to be discussed at a very high level.
What do phenomena such as non-locality or the instantaneous reaction of entangled particles as they occur in the world of the very smallest have to do with paranormal phenomena? What connection do you see?
It is not possible to prove that there are any connections at all. It is only a matter of conjecture, but there are good reasons for this. Because there are clear parallels, what is observed in the world of the smallest particles, what we call non-locality, is also described by many people who have had near-death experiences, something I myself have studied in great detail. Those who have experienced near-death experiences report, for example, that they were able to move by their own will alone, that they no longer experience distances that would have taken time to overcome. For example, as soon as you want to, you are immediately on another continent, instantly. This also demonstrates a certain parallelism with the dissolution, or rather, the non-existence of time. Near-death experiences repeatedly speak of time either no longer existing or existing in a different form. Their experience has an incredible length, density and intensity. What we would perhaps need weeks for in normal life and within the possibilities of our brain capacity can take place in 1 or 2 seconds during a near-death experience. In the brief moment of an accident, for example, the brain would be completely overwhelmed by the wealth of impressions. People therefore describe an expansion of time, a cancellation of time. This is another parallel, and there is another one, namely the wave-particle duality. In this dual function, I see a certain parallel to what near-death experiencers experience when it comes to their bodies. There are near-death experiencers who say quite clearly, I had a body, I had hands, feet, I could also touch things, but others seem to report the opposite. They experience themselves as a kind of cloud, as something indeterminate. And still, others experience both at the same time. They experience a body and also disembodiment. This is also a kind of blurring that can be observed. It seems paranormal, but there are certain structures, so there are certain parallels to quantum physics. But whether there is a causality is an open question. It's simply a set of circumstances that stand out.
This means that there are clear parallels between consciousness phenomena and quantum phenomena, but it remains unclear whether there are any connections.
I think it's right and it's justified to think about it. It shouldn't be banned. That may sometimes be a problem. There are critical scientists who don't want to allow such thoughts. A few years ago, for example, there was an article in the Journal of Near-Death Studies by two quantum physicists with unusual names. One was called Marlok Zernov and the other Mork Zovsky, if I remember correctly. They criticized exactly that and said quantum physics only concerns the very, very small without exception. There is no reason to assume that what is observed here could also occur in the macroscopic larger world. This is, of course, an important point that you make. There are theorems in quantum physics about how information can be transmitted. And when measuring a particle, when determining its location, pure chance obviously plays an important role. So a lot of things very quickly become hypothetical. That's why many scientists want to keep their feet on the ground. They say, you are making connections that may not even exist.
What are the consequences of this? Is it a question of being more cautious about establishing and constructing connections between the world of atoms and the spiritual inner world?
There are questions that occupy us enormously and have not been resolved. This concerns physics, but also consciousness. A kind of bridge is being sought here and there. In physics, this is a bridge between quantum theory and Einstein's general theory of relativity, the theory of gravity. These theories are not yet compatible. And as far as consciousness is concerned, we have matter, the brain and the phenomenon of consciousness. That is also difficult to reconcile. We cannot explain how something like consciousness emerges from matter. And if we assume that consciousness is immaterial, we have no idea how something immaterial is supposed to interact with matter. We need a bridge in both cases. To come back briefly to the basic problem with physics, which is concretely evident there. There we have this world as we know it, determined by gravity, the general theory of relativity. There is causality, cause and effect, which is crucial for everything that happens. Space and time, locality, continuity are also crucial. And in quantum physics, we find exactly the opposite. Not only locality, but non-locality is evident here. And there is no causality, not cause and effect, but probabilities. That is not compatible. It doesn't seem to fit together. A bridge is needed. Clever physicists who deal with this world problem assume that higher dimensions play a role. There is the string theory, the multiverse theory. What intuitively appeals to me the most is Burkhard Heim's quantum field theory. All these super theories, which summarize gravitational theory and quantum theory, require not just one, but several higher dimensions. In these higher dimensions, Heim also includes dimensions with consciousness. By assuming such dimensions, the fields of physics could come together again and function together. That is very fascinating. And when it comes to the bridge that connects consciousness with matter, a further dimension could also be necessary via which the connection is made. I could imagine that such a higher dimension, which is connected to consciousness, is connected to a finer dimension and quantum physical phenomena. That this also influences the macroscopic and that we can discover this bridge. But that is really extremely speculative. I'll leave that to people who want to think more deeply about it.
All in all, quantum physics and near-death experiences. Is there a connection? What is your conclusion?
It is quite conceivable that there is a connection, but perhaps it's ultimately not that important. What I find interesting is that if you ask those who have had a near-death experience about it, it turns out that such theories are not important to them at all. They have had their experience and they are absolutely convinced of what they have experienced. How it works is not so important. You could also ask, How many of us really understand exactly why we see something? Nevertheless, we enjoy seeing. An explanation is not absolutely necessary, it's about the experience. I also find it highly fascinating to deal with theories, but I can also quickly let these mind games go. They are ultimately irrelevant. I would also like to warn against becoming too fixated on theories as long as something is so highly speculative. What we experience in the physical world is far removed from what goes on in the world of the absolute smallest, what the brightest minds try to understand. Referring to and focusing on this also entails a certain danger. Phenomena such as near-death experiences could fall into disrepute if connections to quantum physics are made as a supposed explanation that are simply too speculative. Or when people talk about quantum healing, who could categorize that correctly? I consider that to be harmful. So all in all, I would advise against associating near-death experiences with quantum physics. Perhaps apart from the parallels I mentioned earlier, which can be drawn, yes, the subject is fascinating, but we can say much more about it.
Dr. Eberhard, thank you very much for your differentiated view of this topic. I think it also offers a lot of food for thought. Thank you very much for the interview.